Hey guys, this is Dirk Dallas here with Adorama TV, and today I wanted to talk to you about the various focusing options inside the DJI Go app. I also want to share with you how I nail focus every single time. If you've ever gotten soft footage, or you've had trouble setting focus, or maybe if you've struggled understanding the different focus modes, then this tutorial is for you. So let's get started. The first way that you can focus is using the default autofocus or AF setting. AF works just like the focus on a smartphone's camera, where you tap on something and it automatically focuses to the proper focal length. If you have the volume turned up on your smart device, you will hear a beep, which lets you know that focus has been set. One tip I like to recommend is setting your custom button 1 to always center focus. To do this, go to the main menu by clicking on the three little dots on the top right-hand side of the screen. Then go to controller, and there you'll see C1. I set center focus for the C1 button because it's on the same side as my shutter button. This means that whenever I click the C1 button, whatever I am pointing the center of the camera at, that will come into focus. This is why I always like to have the grid lines on or the center point enabled. You can set both of those by going to the camera settings menu on the right-hand side of your screen, just below the record shutter button. It's important to know that in AF mode, your focus can slip or it can change from an accidental tap. To prevent this, you can lock and hold the focus by either switching to the exposure setting or switching to the manual focus setting. All right, so the next focusing option is manual focus, or MF. I like to use this when recording video because it locks and holds the focus, ensuring that my focus won't slip or change automatically or even by accident. You can enter manual focus mode by clicking on the AF-MF setting. Once doing that, your focus square will turn to white and say MF. To the right, you will now see a little option pop up that will let you now scroll to focus. This is represented by a flower that refers to the macro mode for shooting objects that are closer to the camera, and then down below, the infinity mode for objects that are off in the distance. All you need to do is scroll with your finger until your subject is in focus. One feature I like to turn on to help me with focusing is focus peaking threshold. You can find focus peaking threshold by going to the camera settings menu and then the gear icon. I tend to keep mine at the high setting because it's more strict with what it thinks is in focus and it's less distracting. Once you turn this feature on, your display will show red fringe lines around objects. This really just serves as a visual indicator for what the camera thinks is in focus. This doesn't always work perfectly, but it can definitely help you figure out what is in focus if you have a small screen or you have outside glare or even if you're shooting in low light. And don't worry, those red lines, they won't show up on your footage. Now, when you're in manual focus mode, I can't tell you what exactly to scroll to because this is all going to depend on how far away you are from your subject. But finding a setting closer to the macro option is great for things that are close by. And setting your focus closer to the infinity option is great for subjects that are far away. Now, one tip to help you get more familiar with the scroll to focus option is you can switch your drone to autofocus mode, then tap on your subject, and then click back over to manual focus to see where the dial is, which means that's what the focus is set to. The last focusing option is autofocus continuous, or AFC. To turn on this option, you need to go to the camera settings menu and then switch it on where it says enable AFC mode. AFC tries to make sure that the camera is continuously in focus. Basically, the camera will keep refocusing on the center automatically, so you don't have to remember to keep tapping to focus. AFC can be really helpful for beginners who are overwhelmed with all the focus settings or who don't want to constantly remember to tap to focus or lock focus. AFC can also be great for those who just want to snap photos, but it is important to remember that focus slipping issues can arise when you are recording video in this mode. So to wrap this up, I'll say that I like to use the autofocus mode when shooting photos and then the manual focus mode when shooting video. I think it's best though for you to try out each option and see which one works for you.
All right guys, well hey, thanks so much for tuning in to Adorama TV. I hope that was helpful to you. If you have any questions, please leave a comment down below and I will check them out. I'm Dirk Dallas and I'll see you guys next time.